is biomedical based and what are its characteristics. Now in today's class we are going to see the color coding and the type of container schedule according to the biomedical waste rules 1998. So these biomedical waste are highly infectious and highly toxic, so that is the reason why we cannot mix these particular biomedical waste with the normal municipal waste or e-waste or a different kind of a waste. We cannot mix it. So for that reason, in order to have the segregation, what we have done, we have divided the biomedical waste into the different categories. Regarding this, we have studied in the last class, and then the type of waste and its disposal technique. But we are going to use the different kind of a color coding depending upon these particular categories. We are going to have it, we are going to store it. So that is the reason why we are going to just overview it, what is category 1, 2, 3, and then we will be going to the color coding. Now category 1 will be having the human anatomical waste. It is going to be disposed by incineration and deep burial. Category 2 will be having the animal waste. Category 3 will be having microbiology and biotechnological waste. Category 4 will be having waste sharps. Then category 5 will be having the discarded medicine and the cytotoxic. 6 soiled waste. Then category 7 will be having solid waste. It is generated from the sharps such as the tubing, catheters and etc. Then category 8 will be having the liquid waste, which include the laboratory and washing and housekeeping etc. Category 9 will be having the incineration ash. Category 10 will be having the chemical waste. Now these different kind category of a waste, in order to have the proper identification, because we cannot mix the sharps with the, we cannot mix it with the different kind of organs. So in order to store all these different category waste in a different color coding containers or the plastic bags, we have done the color coding and the container schedule for according to the schedule 2. So for that reason we have seen it. Now we are going to see what are the different color coding with its categories. Now in color coding we are going to use 4 types of colors. One is yellow, red, blue or white, and next is last one is black. We are going to have it, the different types of container that we are going to use is plastic bag and a disinfected container or plastic bag, then puncture proof bags, and then again the plastic bag. Then we have already discussed regarding these categories and then the treatment. Now we will see yellow color blacks plastic bags will be used for what all categories. So we are going to use this yellow color plastic bag. We are going to have the human anatomical waste. In this we are going to have the tissues, body organs, right? And again we are going to use the yellow color bag for animal waste, which will be having the animal tissues, organs, parts, blood, fluid, and then the research waste. All these we are going to have in category 2. Category 3 will be the waste which are going to be generated in the microbiology laboratory. Then category 6 we are going to have the different types of dressing, so soiled, plaster, cast, lines, beddings, etc. So the yellow color will be utilized for category 1, category 2, 3 and 6. All these will be having normally the waste body parts, then bed, your clothings, dressings, all these things together in overall we can have in category 1, 2, 3 and 6. This we can treat or we are going to dispose it by using either incineration or deep burial. So yellow color we need to remember 1, 2, 3 and category 6. Now this particular red
category 3, category 6 and category 7 will be put under the red kind of a plastics or a disinfected container. We'll see what is category 3. Category 3 will be having microbiological waste that is going to be get generated in the laboratories. Then the solid waste, which are having the plaster, then again the dressings, cotton, etc. Category 7 will be having the plastic solid waste, which includes the sharps such as tubing, catheters, intravenous sets, etc. So this will be put under the red color plastic bags. It should be disinfected. Then we are going to treat it by using the autoclaving and microwaving or the chemical treatment. Now in the next category, we are either using the blue or white color coatings for category 4 and category 7. This will be having the puncture proof bags. We should keep it. Now what is category 4? It is going to have the waste sharps. Okay, so here we are going to have the scalpels, then blades, needles, syringes, as these kind of sharps, they may, if it is in a contact with the person, right, directly, it may create the wounds. So this may be very, very dangerous for the people who, for the person who is in direct contact with the, these sharps, and by mistake, if any wounds are going to happen on his body with these sharps, then it may infect that particular person also who is going to handle these kind of waste sharps. Then category 7 will be having again the plastic solid waste, which is going to, as we have discussed, it is going to have the sharps with the tubes, catheters, etc. Again, it is going to have the sharp points to it. So we need to place these kind of a waste into the white kind of a white or blue kind of a containers, and it can be treated or it can be disposed by using the autoclaving or the microwaving. Then next is, we are going to use the black kind of a container. We will be using it, right, for the category 5, category 9 and category 10. Category 5 will be having the discarded medicines. That means the expired medicines or some waste kind of a medicine. We will be having it in the category 5. Then category 9 will be having the incineration ash. Okay, so here in the category 9, we have the ashes from the biomedical waste, that after burning, whatever the ash is going to remain, that we will be having in the category 9. Category 10 will be having the chemical waste, chemicals used in the your laboratories, disinfecting and insecticides. This we are going to have under the category 10. So overall, 5, 9 and 10, we are going to have the, together it is nothing but the ashes and the discarded medicine and the chemical waste we are going to have in the black kind of a containers. So this is how we are going to segregate the different types of a waste into the different types of different color coded container according to divided into its various categories. The biomedical management steps we are going to discuss now. Now it will be having the right from the generation to right from disposal, all these will be coming under the biomedical waste management steps. So first is the segregation, then collection, then storage, then transportation, and then to the disposal. Okay, now what is segregation? Segregation is a basic separation of different categories of waste generated from at a source, and thereby reducing the risk as well as cost of handling and the disposal. Segregation is most important step in the biomedical waste management. Effective segregation can alone ensure the effective biomedical waste management in accordance with the Schedule 1 biomedical rules 1998. So this has to be done according to the Schedule 1, according to the different kind of categories. Now how does this segregation is going to help us? Okay, segregation reduces the amount of waste needs special handling and treatment. Effective segregation process prevents the mixture of medical waste like sharps with the general municipal waste, prevents illegal reuse of the waste, biomedical waste like syringes, needles, plastics, etc. And then recycled plastic can be used for non-food grade applications. Okay, so this segregation has to be done at a source level itself. Means the moment we are going to generate the different kind of a waste, we should keep it according to the different categories, we should keep it into the different color coded containers, and these particular containers should have these kind of a markings on it. That is, C is nothing but the cytotoxic. That is, we use it for the different kinds of biomedical medicinal waste, right? We are going to use it. That is the category, especially we are going to use this for category 10, and we are going to category 10, 9, we are going to use it. Okay, then this biohazard is usually, it is used for the infectious kind of a waste material. That is, we are going to store the various kinds of man tissues into the different types of the plastic bags. That is, we are going to use the yellow plastic bag, we will be using it, yellow and red, we will be using it for the different kind of the human and animal tissues. So this is regarding the biohazard. So if the tissues, if any waste or if any body parts are there, then it should be kept in containers should have this biohazard symbol. Next is, we are going to see regarding the collection. Okay, when coming to the collection, the collection of biomedical waste involves the different types of a container sources in the which are, it should be kept in front of the laboratories, wards, kitchens, corridors, etc. And the container should be placed in such a way that 100% collection is achieved. The sharp must be always kept in the puncture proof container to avoid the injuries or to the person who is going to handle it. Now, next is the storage. Whatever the biomedical waste we are going to have it, right? We should not keep it for a longer period of time, as it is a cytotoxic and it is a biohazard. We cannot keep it for the longer period of time. Why is, the person who is moving into that particular area, he may be get infected, or it may be toxic to that particular person. So there is a restriction on this, right? According to the rules 1998, what it tells is 8 to 10 hours we can store these biomedical waste into the big hospitals. That is, up to about 250 beds we can store it for 8 to 10 hours. For the nursing homes, that is the small nursing homes and the clinics, we can, whatever the waste material that we are going to generate, we can store it for the period of around 24 hours. Okay, so this is regarding the storage. This we need to maintain it strictly, because these are cytotoxic as well as the biohazard. Okay, next is regarding transportation. Regarding transportation, should be carried out either in a trolleys or in a covered wheelbarrows. The manual loading should be avoided as far as possible, and the bags or container of the biomedical waste should be properly, it should be tied, and before transporting the bag, it should be accompanied with the signed document by the nurse or a doctor is a must, and along with the date, shift, quantity and destination. Okay, then we will be seeing special vehicles must be used for to prevent the access to and direct contact with the waste by the transportation operator or scavenger. It should be avoided. Okay, direct contact we should avoid it. The transport containers should be properly enclosed. It should not be open to the atmosphere. Okay, and the driver must be trained in procedures he must follow in case of any accident, spillage. It should be possible to wash the interior of the containers thoroughly. Okay, and we needed to have certain kind of a personal safety devices, or the we call it as an PPE, that should be utilized for a person who is going to handle these particular waste. So he should wear the gloves, the heavy rubber duty gloves should be used, and it should be bright yellow in color. After handling the waste, the gloves should be thoroughly washed twice. Okay, the gloves should be washed after every use with the carbolic soap, and it should be disinfected. The second thing is, we should use either apron, gowns or suits and apparel. Okay, apparel is worn to prevent the contamination of clothing and to protect the skin. It should be made up of cloth or impermeable material such as plastic. Okay, the people working in incinerator chamber should have gowns or suits made up of non-flammable material. Masks, why we need to use mask is the various types of masks, goggles, face shields are used against the various infectious agents. It is mandatory for a person working in incinerator chamber to wear mask covering both nose and mouth. Okay, boots, we should also use the boots, the leg covering boots. It should be used when we are going to deal with these infectious material, biomedical materials, because if we are having any kind of a wounds on our body and on our foot part, if we are in touch with those infectious material, then that infections may be touching us. So we should use some personal protective equipment. Regarding the treatment, treatment and then the disposal, we are going to have the different kinds of a treatment, that is chemical treatment is there, then thermal processes is there, then mechanical process is there, and eradication process, then biological process is there. Regarding this, we are going to discuss in detail in the next class. Okay. In today's class, we have covered the biomedical rule, the schedule 1. And then we have seen the various kinds of color coding of containers along with the categories, how we need to have, that is the schedule 2 according to your solid waste management rules 1998. Then we have seen the biomedical management steps, in that segregation, collection, storage and transportation we have seen, along with the various kinds of personal protective equipments. Along with that, we have seen overviewed what are the different disposal or the treatment techniques. Now, this is regarding your in today's class, and see this color coding is, and your schedule 1 and schedule 2, this will be very, very important as per your examination point of view. Normally, they will be asking you regarding this color coding is much more important, but you needed to study the category schedule 1 also, because to study the schedule 2, we need to have the base of schedule 1. Okay, so this is very, very important kind of a question, along with the biomedical waste management steps also is going to be very, very important aspect as per your examination are concerned.